American National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan, wrapping up his three-day visit to Beijing by meeting the most powerful person in China. President Xi Jinping also heads the Central Military Commission, China's apex military body. Sullivan is the first US NSA to visit China in 8 years. And the idea is to dial down tensions between the two superpowers ahead of the US elections in November. The White House said both sides welcomed ongoing efforts to maintain open lines of communication, including planning for a leader-level call in the coming weeks.
President Biden is committed to responsibly managing this consequential relationship to ensure that competition does not veer into conflict or confrontation, and to work together where our interests align. We are committed to maintaining high-level diplomacy, and to this end, President Biden looks forward to engaging with you again in the coming weeks.
Xi told Sullivan that China is committed to stable, sustainable development of ties with the US.
面对变换交织的国际形势，各国需要团结协作，而不是分裂对抗。人民希望开放进步，而不是封闭倒退。尽管中美两国各自情况和中美关系都发生了很大的变化，但是中方致力于中美关系稳定健康可持续发展的目标没有变。
Sullivan also met General Zhang Yuxia, who is number 2 in the Central Military Commission, and pushed for enhanced working-level military-to-military talks. According to the White House, both sides noted the importance of regular communication and plan to hold a call between the theater commanders in the near future.
President Biden and President Xi set the connection for the relationship at the San Francisco Summit and also set out a substantive agenda for us to work together on areas of mutual interest and also for us to manage carefully the differences in the
relationship. 你提出以我会有说你对军事安全领域或者国际关系的高度关注，我愿此借此机会与您谈谈，就双方共同关心问题交换看法。Sullivan
met Foreign Minister Wang Yi, who described China-US ties as critical, but one that has gone through twists and turns.
我希望
President Biden has been very clear in his conversations with President Xi that he is committed to managing this important relationship responsibly.
Mr. Sullivan, please.